succeedschool.com. Learn to succeed.
Forces. A force is a push or a pull which acts upon a mass and is caused by an object with mass. This is usually, though not always, another object. Contact forces are where two objects are touching and include friction, air resistance, which is really a type of friction, tension, and a normal contact force, such as the reaction force which is currently preventing me from falling through the floor. Non-contact forces act at a distance and are caused by fields and include gravitational attraction, electrostatic attraction and repulsion, and magnetic attraction and repulsion. All forces are vectors. When two objects interact, a pair of opposing forces are produced, one on each object, such as my weight being opposed by the normal contact force from the floor. If two or more forces act upon a single object, the overall force is called the resultant force. To calculate resultant force in one dimension, we add forces if they're in the same direction and subtract forces in opposite directions. In two or three dimensions, we add the forces end to end like this to find the resultant, or use trigonometry to calculate it. Anytime the resultant force is non-zero, we get a change in the momentum of the object proportional to the size of the force. The inertial mass is a measure of how easily a force can change an object's momentum. We just rearrange Newton's second law, F equals ma, to find it. Inertial mass equals force divided by acceleration. Any object with constant velocity has zero resultant force. We say it's at equilibrium. To learn more about forces, please click this video. To watch the whole lightning physics playlist, please click here, and please click here to subscribe.